Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pie My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to compile and run Half-Life 2 on your Raspberry Pi. This whole process is made achievable thanks to a leaked version of the source engine. Despite Half-Life 2 not having an official ARM version, we are able to take this source code and compile it directly on our Raspberry Pi. For this guide to work, there's a few things you will need. First, you will need to own a copy of Half-Life 2 on a Steam account. You'll also need to know the username and password of your account, as you will need these to download the Half-Life 2 game files to your Raspberry Pi. Secondly, you will want to be at least running a Raspberry Pi 5. The extra performance these new versions of the Raspberry Pi offers is significant enough to make Half-Life 2 actually playable. However, these steps will still work on older devices such as the 4, but your experience will be significantly worse. Third, we highly recommend that you run a 64-bit version of Raspberry Pi OS. For this guide, we'll be using Raspberry Pi OS 64-bit Bookworm. However, these same steps will work perfectly fine on Ubuntu. Once you are ready to proceed, open up the terminal on your Raspberry Pi. The first thing we'll need to do is ensure our operating system's packages are all up to date. The first thing we need to do to achieve this is to update the package list, which you can do by typing in sudo apt update and then pressing enter. Once the package list has been updated, you can upgrade any out of date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade hyphen y and then pressing enter. Once the upgrade process has completed, our next step is to install all the packages we need to run and compile Half-Life 2 on our Raspberry Pi. To do this, you'll need to type in sudo apt install wget unzip git then build hyphen essential then c cache and then libsdl2-dev and then libfontconfig1-dev and then libopenal-dev then libjpeg-dev and then libpng-dev space libkel4-gnutls-dev and then libbz2-dev and then after that libedit-dev and then finally python3 and then end this with a hyphen y. This is a long list of packages, but we need them all to be able to compile the Half-Life 2 engine on our Raspberry Pi. To begin the install process, hit enter. Now, before we grab the source code for Half-Life 2 and compile it on our Raspberry Pi, we will need to set up an additional tool called Depot Downloader. We'll be using this tool to grab a specific version of the Half-Life 2 game files later on. If we were just to grab the latest version, we'll run into issues when we try to run Half-Life 2 on our Raspberry Pi. Let's start by creating a directory where we'll store this tool by typing in sudo mkdir-p /opt/depot-downloader. Once created, change into the directory by typing in cd /opt/depot-downloader and then pressing enter. We can now download the tool from their GitHub by typing in sudo space wget space https://github.com/steam-re/depot-downloader/releases/download/depot-downloader/unline3.0.0/depot-downloader-linux-arm64.zip. Once downloaded, we will need to extract the archive by typing in sudo unzip-j depot-downloader-linux-arm64.zip and then pressing enter. We will now want to give this tool execute privileges by typing in sudo chmod plus x and then depot downloader. With that done, we no longer need the archive we downloaded earlier, so we can remove it by typing in sudo rm depot downloader hyphen linux hyphen arm64.zip and then pressing enter. Our next step is to create a folder where we will store the Half-Life 2 source engine code on our Raspberry Pi. You can create this directory by typing in sudo mkdir -opt -hl2-source/. Once you have created the directory, change into it by typing in cd /opt /hl2-source/. Now clone the code by typing in sudo git clone https://github.com/neil-er-user/source-engine.git --recursive and then end it with a space and then a dot. We will now need to configure the source code we just downloaded so that it will compile on our Raspberry Pi. You can do this by typing in sudo -config /prefix=hl2-build-games=hl2-disable-warns. Once configured, we can now compile the code by typing in sudo -prefix /waf /build -p -v and then press enter. This compilation process will take considerable time even on a Raspberry Pi 5. For us, it took about 20 minutes to complete, so now is a good time to take a break if you need one. With the Half-Life 2 engine now compiled on our Raspberry Pi, we can now run the install script to put all the files where it needs to be. You can run this by typing in sudo -free /waf and then install. Once installed, we want to move all these files to its own directory by typing in sudo mv -hl2/opt/. This will set up a new directory where we will download the Half-Life 2 game files to. To download the right version of the Half-Life 2 game files, we're using the Depot Downloader software that we set up earlier. To run this tool, you'll want to type in sudo /opt/depot-downloader/depot-downloader /250-hyphen-app /220-hyphen-depot /221-hyphen-manifest /36662189914479-5038 then /dir /opt/hl2/username and then follow this up with a space and then the username of your Steam account. Press enter to begin the download process. Before it can download the Half-Life 2 game files, you will be required to enter the password for your account. Additionally, if you have SteamGuard set up, you will need to approve this connection. Once the files are finished downloading, you have successfully installed Half-Life 2 to your Raspberry Pi. Before we can start playing this game on our Raspberry Pi, there's another thing we'll need to do, and that is take ownership of our new directory with your current user. You can take ownership of these files by typing in sudo chown -R $, then user all in uppercase, then the colon symbol, then /opt/hl2/, and then press enter. We're finally at the point that we can run Half-Life 2 on our Raspberry Pi. To do this, we will need to first change into the correct directory by typing in cd /opt/hl2. Once we're in the right directory, we can run Half-Life 2 by typing in .hl2_launcher and pressing enter. While booting up Half-Life 2, you might run into a set local error. You can ignore this warning and simply press OK to proceed. The very first thing you'll want to do after running Half-Life 2 is to adjust its settings. By default, it loves to set everything to high. Open up the options screen, then change the video. Now first, you want to make sure your resolution is set to something more like 720p. Once you've set this, click the Advanced button. On here, you can then control all the particular different video options. I highly recommend using this time to set everything to low and especially disabling anti-aliasing. We're using this chance to see how it will kind of perform with slightly higher options, but as you'll soon see, this will significantly impact the frames. You can then proceed with your new settings by clicking OK. The game may briefly freeze up for a second or two while it reloads its assets. To give you an idea of how Half-Life 2 runs on the Raspberry Pi, we'll open up the console and type in the command cl_show_fps(1). This will display the current frames per second up in the top right hand corner. We can now show how this runs by starting a new game and selecting the first chapter. For the sake of time, we'll skip a bit of the intro. As you can see, Half-Life 2 is actually somewhat playable on the Raspberry Pi. Don't expect to get the highest frames per second, as the Raspberry Pi is still quite a weak device. However, if you are prepared to deal with a few frame hitches now and then, as well as low frames per second in certain areas, the game is definitely playable. Indoor scenes can get up to actually quite a good frame rate. Skipping ahead again, you can see that once we get to an outside scene, the performance does start to tank a little bit. This will differ depending on where you are in the game, as some sequences still will perform fine. But again, if you're happy to put up with a bit of jankiness or even decrease the resolution even further, the game could actually be playable all the way through with a decent frame rate. Hopefully at this point you have also managed to get Half-Life 2 up and running on your Raspberry Pi. While it requires a few different steps, it is kind of neat actually being able to play this game on such a weak device. And especially a device this game was never intended to run on in the first place. If you have liked this guide, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.